Hi, welcome to my SQL Server Reporting Service Double Hop issue. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to fix the error or problems and a basic knowledge about that and how to configure it and how to troubleshoot a problem. Okay, things should be simple, straightforward, everyone can follow. So without further ado, let's open up a browser, go to a reporting service as we normally do, and then the first thing you notice that you have to enter username and password, and second thing will be the page, like a configuration page, may take some time to load up, which is because the SPN has not set yet. So once we set that, you will see this page load up much quicker. And second thing is when you load up a report and you will get this error, first of the thing, you'll probably have some connection issue. It is a connection issue. So let's set the SPN to solve the problem, the first logon problem and display problem. Let's go to the page again. As you can see now, the page load up a lot quicker. No need to enter username and credential. Now, but the report, let's look at the report. That's still coming out with error. So that's another bit of the thing we need to solve. That's the delegation. We need to dedicate the service account and allow that to pass your credential to the other server in order to get the report. So now if you go to the page again and try to load up the report and still getting error, what's going on? And let's look at the Kerberos ticket. You don't have the special ticket to grant you permission to other server. So let's open up Edge, IE. The Edge is a replacement anyway. So let's look at the report again. Still didn't work. So in this case, I think you look at the Kerberos ticket again. We need to purge it. And before we go any further, we try to look at the report again, and as you can see, it's not working again. So it's not working on either browser. You can try again, nothing really happened. So what's going on here? Because as you can see, the Kerberos ticket already there, but still not loading. The issue is actually just the browser just caged the credential. So let's try again now. It's working perfectly fine, no issues. And then I will show you another setting which in the browser you have to configure before you can pass your authentication through. So that's another important part apart from setting that SPN and delegation. Well, as you can see, the delegation ticket's already granted. So that's the first important things on the DC. And let's cover some theory first for this single sign-on stuff. It's actually boiled down to the Kerberos negotiation or authentication. So in the lab, we have this setup. Basically, we have three servers. One is the client server, which is DC. The other two are the SQL server. And the middle one with SSR install, and the one on the right is the normal SQL server with a database. And we use the GSMA account for the reporting service, which is pretty easy to maintain and highly recommended for you if you want to configure a SQL service, including your SQL server service as well. But in this demo, I just configured for SQL reporting service, which is more than enough for this demo. And so next bit we will want to see is the Kerberos authentication. So as I mentioned before, this double hop issue is boiled down to Kerberos authentication. So there are three parts you need to look into. So just in a nutshell, there's three areas you need to look. So the first one, SPN, service account delegation, which we have already seen. earlier in the demo, which is actually configured on the DC domain controller, and you need to be domain administrator in order to configure that. And the second part is SSR authentication type, which is only available on the SSR server, reporting server. I will show you the configuration path and the content in it, which we'll cover that later. And the third thing is the application and script, application including your browser, script including your Python, PowerShell, etc. And in terms of Kerberos authentication, I won't go into detail. You can have a look at David's video. He actually give you a lot more detail on how it works behind the scenes. And after that, we should have everything ready for Kerberos authentication. We'll cover the middleman later on as well. So in terms of verification, in the browser, you need to have your domain name in a local intranet instead of trust site, which is very important. If you have that in the wrong place, it will not work. And you can publish that via good policy or just edit that registry key that will do the job. For command or script, PowerShell is the most advanced and troubleshooting tools. So out of the box, you don't have to configure anything, load any module in order to communicate with the Kerberos. So you can just issue that command, you can get a report straight away from the server. But other scripting tool or commands like curl or Python, they have some limitation as I find. So I find you don't have any modules that work with the single sign-on double hop issue for Python. So if you know anything for that or solution, feel free to comment down below and let me know. Yeah, that would be good. Share around with people who may have the same issue. So thanks so much for this. In terms of troubleshooting, there's a few things you need to keep in mind. One is your firewall, because your SSR server need to send a Kerberos request ticket to from your SSR to the DC. So that's a capture from your Wireshark. So as you can see, it's actually using the port. So that's why you are seeing that capture there. And on the SSR server sites, you have the log you can look for any error like anonymous authentication error. That's probably you can find it in that log. On the Sky machine or the SSR server, you under the system log you can see this error, which mainly just a Kerberos authentication error. So on the config file on this SSR site, so that's the config file you should look for. The mainly two things you need to look for are the authentication type and the username and user seed. I will show you that a bit later. And sorry about that. Also you can use two commands to troubleshoot your Kerberos authentication. One is klist. You can list your current Kerberos ticket. And the important bit is the deallocation bit in the ticket. So if you have deallocation bit, that's the deallocation ticket. So you can use that to pass your authentication through to other server to get authenticated and then resolve problem. The other thing is the Kerberos patch. It's always a good idea to patch your Kerberos ticket before you, if you restarted make any changes restarting the SQL reporting server, for example, you have to patch your ticket and retry again. Okay, without further ado, let's go back to the lab and have a look at the server we have set up earlier. So according to the PowerPoint presentation, this is the first server, client server, this is the middleman with SQL and SSR install. The last server is just the SQL with one database. So let's go back to the middle server and have a look at the configuration. So for example, the GSMA account is actually being used for the reporting service, and there's an important configuration on the reporting server. The first one being the config file, which is located there, and two portions you need to taking care of. The first one is reservation, the other one is authentication. Under the reservation section, there are two sections. One is for the API section, so reporting server, which is associated with that bit in the configuration manager. So the other bit is the report, that's the second bit, which where you configure that's GUI place where you configure your reports and permissions and data store, etc. So that's the important places you need to look at. The other thing is your service account. That's one way you configure it. However, when you save your file, your service account may change. For example, your seat can change, service account name can change. So make sure you open the file, make sure they are the same. Save it and restart your reporting service. So that's important. And also the authentication type, that's the authentication type you need for Kerberos delegation or double hop to work, which is the other two, just you don't need them, optional, or you can include them as well, so it doesn't really affect, but as long as you have the first one on the top, negotiation one. So on the first server, as you can see, we only have one database, and on this middle server, we have two reporting database. So that's pretty much it for the middle server. On the client server, as you can see from the early demo, that's what we have already configured. Basically just set the SPN for that service account against the server, which is the SSR server. And we can see once we configure that, you should see the following. Takes a bit longer, but that's what you finally see. That service account is actually bound to that server. Okay, and that's already covered. And the delegation, let's do a quick verification for the PowerShell script. So use PowerShell script, you can do double hop and get the report from the reporting server without any issue, as you can see. There, the PDF already generated, and the report is looks exactly the same as you have seen earlier. Back to the delegation, that's the initial delegation before you run that command. So after you run it, actually you have to enable that feature, otherwise you won't be able to see the attribute editor tab. So let's go down after ran the command earlier. So now you can see the it has changed to 81,000. That's the delegation already for that service account already enabled. Okay, so I think that's pretty much it I need to cover in this video. If you like it, please feel free to share the video and if you appreciate my time of making this video, also please keep a like button. And so hopefully we'll see you in another video, and thanks for watching. All right, bye.